Has the Three Waters controversy drowned out the urgent need for safe drinking water? According to some of our leading public health researchers, the answer is yes. They've banded together in a bid to remind Aotearoa of the dangerous consequences of water contamination. They say behind the debate remains a very serious equity issue that political posturing won't solve. Dr. Tim Chambers is one of those researchers and joins us now. Morena, Tim, can you take us back? What was the whole point of Three Waters back before all of the politicking sort of came into play?
Yeah, so the main point really is that the current water system for Three Waters, that's storm waste and drinking water, is not sufficient to protect public health. And we know that every year over 30,000 people get sick from their drinking water, and around 500,000 people have to boil their water to boil out and kill bacterial contamination. And so those are really stark issues. We also know that in 2016, we had one of the largest waterborne outbreaks in the developed world. 8,000 people got sick and 4 people died in Havelock North.
How frustrating is it then that the politicisation of this has sort of muddied the waters, so to speak?
Yeah, exactly. So the point of our article really was to highlight that we do have these central public health problems with the current system, but also that even if we thought that this level of public health burden was acceptable, that it's actually financially unsustainable to continue the way that we're going. It's projected that we've got around a $180 billion infrastructure gap over the next 30 years, and that if councils were to try and meet that today, they'd have to increase the money that they take from rates by 2 to 3 times.
Yeah, that means higher rates, right? And I'm guessing that's another political issue potentially for people to have to deal with.
Yeah, and so that's what Three Waters is trying to achieve really, is to try and make sure that we get a high level of performance at a lower cost. And they do that by restructuring into these 4 entities rather than having 67 different territorial authorities responsible for drinking water.
Tim, how can the reforms be improved, do you think?
Yeah, that's a good question. I think that's sort of been hashed out now in the House. But I think what we do need to focus on is that those are really the core elements there, is around protecting public health and making sure that we have a financially sustainable model going forward.
And what would you like to see from the government going forward?
Well, I think we would like to see actually more in the public discourse around focusing on how we're going to solve these major public health issues and actually how are we going to finance the infrastructure deficit that we've got today.
And on that, do you have some ideas about how that might be best to tackle that in terms of financing it?
Yeah, well, there's been proposals. I mean, the key element there is by amalgamating all of these entities into into 4 entities, what you're essentially doing is getting entities that have much better balance sheets, so they're allowed to borrow a lot more money at lower interest rates, and they can make those major infrastructure upgrades that are required in order to protect public health.
How frustrating is it then that you have instances like the other day when the government sort of misstepped, whether that was really at the crux of the issue, a really bad thing, but seen to be bad? How frustrating is it that that sort of gets in the way of moving this process along as well?
Yeah, and there are some other legitimate issues around privatisation, for example, that do need further discussion. And, you know, there are really good protections in the bill against privatisation, and that, you know, you need to have a referendum of the people within the entity. 75% or more people have to agree. The representative board has to agree, and all of the councils have to agree to privatisation. And the intent of that government misstep, I guess, of the entrenchment, is really just trying to hold politicians to the same level of protection as the public.
Tim, help us to focus our minds. One last key message moving forward about what this is really about and what's important here.
Yeah, it's about creating sustainable Three Waters infrastructure that will protect public health going into the future to ensure that nobody will get sick from their drinking water.
Tim Chambers from Otago University, thanks very much for joining us here on Breakfast this morning.